Economic growth and delivering value for investors is critical to those in the fund industry. At a recent Chatham House conference, the question was put on the table as to how to keep delivering growth, especially in developed markets. Here are some key takeaways from that conversation.
Well, I mean, the presentation that we were looking at was one questioning how do we have a long-term sustainable growth model? And of course, you know, there's a lot of gyrations in sort of near-term events to work through, you know, Brexit, understanding the new administration within the US, all that kind of thing, which of course makes people nervous. You know, when we look longer term, there is still a good opportunity for some level of positive growth out there, and we shouldn't be over-concerned about the outlook for asset returns. Yes, simple asset returns will probably be lower. Long-term growth is going to be constrained by demographics, which means probably a lower equilibrium interest rate, which in turn probably means lower asset returns. But we're getting a growth of different areas as well. Some of the things to be positive about. Regulation and the surge in that is beginning to come to an end. Now, I think it would be far-fetched to assume, as some of the other panelists also corroborated, that we see a sudden bonfire of regulation. But the reality is we're likely to see this being a high watermark. Regulation is probably now appropriate, and that means that the additional capital raising that's been done across the financial industry may be slowing some, which means that you have a better outlook perhaps for earnings across the financial sector. Another area, of course, generally is looking at areas where you can pick up returns from liquidity premium, things like infrastructure investment, whether it be debt or equity, really nice yields relative to the bond market, indeed relative to dividend yields in the broader equity market. But then the big one to my mind, which we perhaps mismeasure today, is the impact of technology. And what we are seeing is a huge potential surge towards automation and digitization, which may mean that the economy grows a little bit faster in productivity terms, even as we see demographic trends pointing somewhat downwards. Where does that leave us? We have a positive outlook on terms of long-term growth. We see around 1.5 percentage points developed market growth, around 4.5 percentage points for emerging market real growth over the next 10 to 15 years. And that gives us asset returns from the equity market, developed market, somewhere around the 6% kind of range. We'd expect returns coming in from fixed income to be some way behind that, but there are opportunities still out there, even though it's a fairly uncertain world that we face today. Longer term, opportunities will always exist for investment.